I am 100% that all of us who are here have targets, goals, and dreams to achieve. That is what I call the summits of life. The summits of life for human beings are so important that some people are able to die to achieve their summits of life. I'm going to talk to you about the Everest, the highest summit in the world. And in this context, I call the Everest the summits of many lives, because there are so many people that have tried to climb it and they have died. And still there are so many people that are trying to climb it that I think it is the summit of many lives. As you probably know, the Everest is the highest mountain in the world. It belongs to the so-called 14 giants in the world, as you can see in my t-shirt. It is the most climbed mountain in the world. More than 4,000 people has been able to climb and to be at the very top. But at the same time, more than 300 people have died trying to get it, including the last accident that happened in April 2014. However, it's not the most dangerous one. The most dangerous one, talking in percentage rates, the most dangerous one is the K2, the second highest mountain in the world. So, what is so special about the Everest is not only that it is the highest mountain in the world, but it is that nobody knows who was first to get it at the very top. So, it is the deepest mysterious legend of the alpinism. Who were first? Maori in Irving, 1924, British. Hilary in Norway, Australian, 1953. The body of Mallory was found in 1999. And scientists were studying his clothes to see if they were able to get at the very top. Scientists said that their clothes were very similar to the ones used by the Scott in the expeditions to the South Pole. So they were warm enough to go at the very top. Besides, there is another argument which says that Mallory and Irving get to the very top. Mallory brought a photograph of his wife in his pocket to put it in the mountain. When they found his body, the photograph was not there anymore. However, officially, it was Hilary in Norway, the first one to get the very top of the Everest in 1953. From a technical point of view, it's very easy to climb the Everest. If you start at midnight from the last campsite, you can be there at 2 in the afternoon. You shouldn't be there later than 2 in the afternoon, because otherwise you are supposed to be quite late. And usually the accidents take place when you get down. So if you start at midnight from the last campsite, the maximum time to be at the very top, it should be 2 in the afternoon. And it is easy from a technical point of view, because there are a lot of landmarks, more than 40 bodies in the way to go up. There are signs. The most famous one, the greeter, saying hello. And the second most famous one is the green boots. As you can see, you go through here. You have to fit him. And then, what are really the threats of the Everest? The dead sun. Scientists say that from 8,000 meters upwards, there is no oxygen enough to have any life there. So you get dead sun, altitude sickness, you get hallucinations, you are not sure where you are, frostbites, your hands, your legs, your lungs, and your heart get frozen. And of course, the cracks, all of them are filled with snow. However, if you feed them, you fall down and you die. If you feel about it, I will tell you the route. It takes 65 days to be climbed, right from the beginning when you start in Madrid and take the plane to Kathmandu, and then when you finish and come back to Spain. It costs $35,000. if you go in groups, or $60,000 if you go, sorry, if you go alone, right? The best month is only 4 months in the year, April, May, October, November. But usually the expeditions go in April and May because it is better weather. For this year, 2014, 45 expeditions are going to climb. However, because of the last accident, as you know, Sherpas are on a strike. And they say that if the government is not going to pay more money to the Sherpas who die, they are not going to go with any of these climbers. So this is the expeditions who ask for permission, but we are not sure these expeditions are going to be up. And this year, more than 300 people want to climb the mountain. And there is a small detail, but very important. You need to fill the body disposal form. It is compulsory. So in case you die, you have to decide if you want your body to leave it in the mountain, if you want your body to take it to Kathmandu, or if you want your body to take it home. It depends on the money, you can pay as well. So in the 21st century, there is a movement, mountain sport movement, which is called the Summits of My Life. I think it's going to become a social movement. It has a vision, it has a mission, it has a lot of values, and it has a lot of discipline and different summits concerning sports, mountain, skiing, running, so on and so forth. And it has one special mission, which I think is important to share with you. Someone once said that we are our dreams. If we don't dream, we are not longer alive. So now, my question for all of us is this one. How far are we willing to go to achieve the summits of our life? And I'm going to read you what Edurne Pasaban, as you know, the first woman in the world who has been able to climb the 14 Giants without oxygen, says. She said, "I have always looked for happiness, and in the mountains I have found something very close to that." That's it.